Afternoon students, now we shall discuss about the lecture, that is a gamma decay or gamma ray emission. When a nucleus emits alpha particle or beta particle, the daughter nucleus, which is in excited state, excited state nucleus returns to less excited state or sometimes to the ground state by emitting gamma rays. So the decay is lead 82 to 10, so which emits excited nucleus electron, that is a beta particle and neutron. So then excited nucleus returns to the ground state and emits the gamma rays. So gamma ray emission with the energy level diagram are shown in figure. So this is shown in figure. So when lead 82 to 10 nucleus emits beta particle, neutron and daughter nucleus, so which is in excited state, there will be a transition from excited state to ground state, which is comparable, which is accompanied by the emission of gamma rays. So bismuth 210, that is its atomic number is 83. So nucleus is also radioactive, which emits beta particle and becomes lead 83 210. Conservation laws in the gamma emission. Following are the conservation laws in the gamma emission. Conservation of charge and nuclear number. The charge and mass number, that is the nuclear number, remains conserved in gamma emission. So excited state nucleus decays into or converted into ground state and which emits the gamma rays. So example, bismuth 83 210, so which returns to the ground state and emits the gamma rays. Here the mass number 210, the mass number of parent nuclei is equal to the mass number of daughter nuclei. So therefore the mass is conserved, or nuclear number is conserved. So this is a nuclear number. So here charge of parent nuclei is equal to charge of daughter nucleus. Therefore charge is conserved. So conservation of linear and angular momentum. So the linear momentum of photon is h nu by c. So the gamma rays emission must make the daughter nucleus recoil with the same linear momentum in opposite direction if parent nucleus is at rest. For conservation of linear momentum, so mv plus h nu by c, where m is the mass of daughter nucleus, v is the velocity of daughter nucleus. So nu is the frequency of photon, c is the velocity of photon. So therefore the sum of momentum of daughter nucleus and photon is equal to zero. So from this the momentum of daughter nucleus is equal to the momentum of photons, so they are in opposite direction. So therefore the momentum is conserved. So since the parent nucleus and the daughter nucleus have the same nucleons, so hence they have the same spin angular momentum. So here the nucleon number, example, the nucleon number of a parent nucleus is equal to the nucleon numbers of daughter nucleus, means the spin of nucleon numbers of parent nucleus is equal to the spin of the sum of spins of nucleons of daughter nucleus. So therefore the spin is conserved. Once again, the sum of spins of nucleons of parent nucleus is equal to the sum of spins of nucleons of daughter nucleus. Therefore the spin is conserved. So hence conservation of linear momentum and angular momentum is conserved for gamma rays. So conservation of mass energy. So in the process of gamma emission, the mass energy remains conserved. Let E suffix I and E suffix F be the energies of higher energy energies of E suffix I and E suffix F be the energies of higher excited and lower excited ground states. That is E suffix I minus E suffix F is equal to H nu. The energy difference between them is equal to photon energy. So from this photon energy is equal to EI E suffix I minus E suffix F by H. So this tells the mass is conserved. So in gamma ray emission, so mass energy also conserved. So conservation of momentum. So according to conservation of momentum, for any reaction to take place, the total momentum before the decay should be equal to the total momentum after the decay process. So consider the example of pair production. So two photons interacting with they produce electron and positron. So here the radiation converted into matter, and here the radiation converted into two particles, electron and positron. So that is here the matter converted, so there is light converted into matter. So let the momentum before the decay process be p1 and p2, means p1 is the momentum of gamma particle, p2 is the momentum of another photon. So the momentum are p3 and p4 after decay. So p3 is the momentum of electron, that p4 is the momentum of positron. So according to the law of conservation of momentum, therefore the sum of moments of these two photons, that is p1 plus p2, the sum of moments of these two particles, that is p3 plus p4, therefore the sum of momentum for two photons before the decay process is equal to the sum of momentum of two particles, that is electron and positron, so after the decay. So hence the momentum is conserved. So the momentum is conserved. So gamma ray emission obeys the conservation of momentum. So next we discuss electron positron pair creation by gamma photons in the vicinity of nucleus. Pair production: if the photon is near to the atomic nucleus, the energy of photon can be converted into electron positron pair of particles, and hence the process is called as pair production. So gamma photon, so that converted into electron and positron. So when gamma photon come to the atomic nucleus, so then its energy converted into two particles, that is the two pairs, electron and positron. So this process is called pair production. So the total energy of pair production is equal to photon energy, means the total energy, that is E is equal to H nu minus 2m0c square. 2m0c square is the energy of rest energy of two particles. H nu is the photon energy. So E is the kinetic energy of a pair. Okay, so the kinetic energy of the sum of kinetic energy of pair and rest energy of two particles is equal to H nu. So from that, E is equal to, so this is the kinetic energy of pair particles, that is E is equal to H nu minus 2m0c square. Here for pair production, so H nu is greater than, the photon energy is greater than 2m0c square. So then the pair production takes place. So this is the curve. Flatted between energy of photons, absorption coefficient. So this curve represents the Compton scattering. So this curve represents the photoelectric absorption. So this curve represents the pair production. So this represents the total absorption curve. So the variation of absorption of gamma rays with the photon energy for lead is shown in figure. So at very low energy, so the photoelectric absorption is chief source of absorption, means the photoelectric absorption takes place very slow. So here at very low energy, the photoelectric absorption is chief. As the energy increases, the photoelectric absorption takes place. Very cheap. So at which the Compton scattering starts. Now the Compton scattering starts. The Compton scattering is predominant at 1 MeV, which predominant at 1 MeV. So when the energy of photon is above 1.02 mega electron volt, pair production dominates over photoelectric absorption and Compton scattering. So total absorption curve is shown by the thick line in the figure. So that is the total absorption curve that is represented by thick line. So the total absorption coefficient curve has a minimum, so at energies, so where the Compton scattering and pair production effects comparable. So which is this curve, this curve reaches to minimum at which the pair production and Compton scattering are comparable or near or equal nearly. So for example, the photon energy is 1.02 mega electron volt, so it is splitted into two energy parts, that is a 0.51 mega electron volt, this is 0.51 mega electron volt. So the sum of these two energies is equal to the photon energy. So when the photon energy is 1.02 mega electron, the photon energy is greater than 1.02 mega electron volt, then the pair production also takes place. Is equal to 1.02 mega electron volt, then I'm so sorry, photon energy is equal to 1.02 mega electron volt, then pair production takes place. So reverse process, electron positron combined with, they produce a gamma photon also. So that is the annihilation process. Here the creation, this is a creation. So the reverse process of this process is called annihilation process. The reverse process of this is called annihilation. So that is the electron combined with the positron then produce gamma photon. So that is called annihilation process. So this is the pair production. So in this process, electron and positron are created. Thank you, students. Now see the answer from starting to ending. Now see the answer from starting to ending. So students, don't forget and subscribe my channel. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.